Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. You are tuned for today. Nothing has started to roll out their most anticipated NothingOS version 3.0. We already did the in-depth preview of beta NothingOS 3.0 for Nothing Phone 1. Its link is available in video description. But today we brought you the leaker version of Nothing Gallery application from new NothingOS 3.0. This gallery application is just amazing. It has simple but the unique look without much complications. It's a super smooth and has some unique features. This application will work on any Nothing phone, and soon I am going to port this build for all the Android devices. So if you are new to our channel, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon to get upcoming notifications for everything related to Nothing devices. Today in this video, we are going to review this new NothingOS gallery application and its installation process. Now without further delay, let's get started. This application should work on any Nothing phone devices which are running on the NothingOS 2.6 and above versions. Here I am using the Nothing Phone 1 with the stable NothingOS 2.6. Let's check out the installation. You have to just download the APK from the video description and install it as a normal application. As Nothing Gallery is inbuilt in the system, it will ask you to update. Just tap OK and done. Now in the app drawer, you will find this gallery application. Its version number is 0.2.32.1115. It's a beta version. Now we'll check out all the new features of this gallery application. It has a simple look. At the bottom we get the three different tabs. One is photo, second is album, and third one is search tab. In the photo section, you will find all your photos and videos, and they will be available date wise. If you open any photos or videos, at the bottom we get the slider for the next photos, so we can switch between the different photos easily. And its rendering is so fast and smooth that I feel that I am watching the one short video of our channel. If you scroll the photos, you get the one scroll bar, and if you scroll with this, it shows the month wise or the date wise photos available in the gallery. So you can easily find all your photos without any hassle. This is pretty useful feature. If you open any single photos, you get the new favorite button to add those pictures in the favorite category. And the selected photos will be get favorite stamp in the gallery, so you can easily find your favorite photos from the list immediately. Under the album section, you don't need to create any separate album category for this. It will be automatically gets created once you select any pictures with the favorite tab, and they all will be available in the favorite album. This one also pretty handy feature. As this is a beta build, Nothing editing tool is not available in the gallery. But you can edit the pictures using the Google Photos or any other editing tools installed in your device. Instead of edit option, you get some useful options too in the three dot menu, like details of the pictures, copy or moving the photos to album, set picture as wallpaper, and duplication of the photos. Let's check out the album tab. Gallery will automatically sort out all your photos or videos in the albums like camera, favorite, videos, etc. using the AI feature. If you want to create your own album, just tap on the plus icon, name it, and done. Last tab is a search tab. This is very useful option I found for the gallery, where you can search all your pictures or the videos with its location, name, date, etc. if you knows about it. I tested the location name to find out the features, and it instantly shown all the pictures as per the location name. That's cool. If you delete any photos or the videos, they will be available in the recently deleted album. Here those photos will remain for at least 30 days, and if you didn't delete or restore it, it will be automatically gets deleted after 30 days. If you select any photos here, you get the two different tabs. At the bottom, one is to delete that photo permanently and other is to restore them again. You will not get any separate widgets in the Nothing widgets for this application. So how you can add its widgets on the home screen? It's simple. Just drag the gallery application icon from the drawer on the home screen. Later you can enlarge this icon so it will look like a real widget on the home screen. You can customize its icon also. Rendering speed for this application is truly amazing. If you close the application and reopen it via widget, it will be immediately gets open with all your photos and videos. So Soon I am going to port this application for all the Android devices running on the Android 15. So stay tuned to our channel. For that, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon to get the notifications of such amazing applications, mods, ROMs reviews and many more. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye bye.